Big G, what does it take to be successful in boxing besides talent?
¿Qué se ocupa para hacer, para llegar en el boxeo, aparte del talento?
Mucha disciplina.
Discipline.
What does that mean, discipline?
You got to be dedicated. ¿Qué quiere decir con disciplina?
Disciplina que se cuide mucho de todos los errores que...
You got to take care of
que
se va a mantenerse those mistakes.
Deportivamente,
pues. Stay in the sport, you know, stay focused.
But we see a lot of fighters super talented. But what he's saying is right. But we see, we know personally, Robert, a lot of fighters that were very talented that just didn't care. The discipline was there. Why is that? Why do they lack the discipline?
A lot of fighters, when they get all the signing bonuses and they think
they made it.
They think they made it. They made it. Sometimes the dads, the family, the moms, the sisters, they think they all made it. You know, that's not gonna last that long. If you don't train, you gotta be dedicated. You gotta always be in shape. You gotta train your ass off. You know, a lot of fighters, and see, the sad thing about it is that a lot of fighters do get away with it, especially the first 15 fights of their career. You know, they're getting paid very well. They got a $100,000 signing bonus. They're getting money every month. So their fights are just extra money to them. And the right matchmakers are picking the right opponents. So they're knocking everybody out in two or three rounds. So they feel, and they get away with it because they don't have to be as good in shape as they can. Most of them, as you see, a lot of those kids that get big signing bonuses and are getting nice fucking paydays for six rounds, a lot of them, what's the first thing that happens? That you could tell, it's because they're babying them. They're getting away with everything. They're not making weight. They're coming in 1, 2, 3 pounds overweight, because that's because they're getting money every month. They're getting away with
it. They're good. They're comfortable.
Don't worry about it. They ask, you know, they're fighting. The promoters are so afraid to lose them that you need 10 ringside tickets. Here you go. There's your 10. Keep them. They're trying to keep them happy. They're trying to. They're trying to baby them. But in the long run, they're gonna hurt them. They're gonna hurt them because they're not training as hard anymore. The fighters, they're getting away with easy knockouts the first 10 fights of the career, 15 fights of the career. So they think that it's gonna be like that every single fight. But comes that day, they're gonna face one of those fucking venados. ¿Cómo se llama?
Yes.
Ni venado.
Luis Alberto López.
Yeah, Luis Alberto López or Salido back in the days when Salido had 10 fucking losses before he became champion.
And he beat Loma.
10 losses before he became champion the first time. So you're gonna get one of those guys that you think, it's an easy fucking fight for me. I don't have to work out. And then you get your ass kicked. It happens in boxing a lot.
So how do you keep a kid that's 18, 19, that never had a dollar, now has a few hundred thousand, that has 100,000 followers, that thinks, how do you keep him grounded?
You talk to him, you give him examples.
Does it help?
If I was the type of trainer that, look, if I go and Mikey just fought and, you know, made millions and millions, and I got my cut, okay? If I'm the type of fighter that's gonna come to the gym and fucking wearing all that jewelry and bragging about all the money that I made, well, my fighters are gonna do the same shit. But I don't teach them, I don't fucking show them that. I don't show them that. I talk to them, I try to get my fighters, like Josh, to talk to a real estate guy to buy his first house. You know, David, what's his name? Navarro, what was that, my Jonathan?
Jonathan.
Fucking, when he signed his first deal with Golden Boy, he didn't waste his money. He was fucking
smart.
It took him 2 years to get his credit up, and he bought his parents a house.
Amazing.
And look, and he's never even had any big fights, but he bought a fucking house.
That's amazing.
Why? Because he sees what, he could have spent his money. He was getting a lot of fucking money every month. I'm telling you, he got a big signing bonus and a lot of money, but he's seen what we do, the smart thing to do, and he...
That's very smart.
And bought his parents a house. Now the parents have their own house. They lived in an apartment their whole life.
Okay, without names, what's the worst case you ever saw someone blowing money? How much?
Many, man. Well, didn't Tyson blow like $300 million?
Not his fault.
No, but...
Yeah.
What do you mean not his fault?
What do you mean?
Yeah, what about Don King with involvement?
Money that was his. he still blew it. Yeah. If Don King would have given him another 50, he would have blew those other 52.
But he was helping people. He was a nice guy.
So maybe instead of 300, maybe he should have had 500. Maybe Don King did get, but he still blew 500.
He's just a very nice guy. He's very generous. He helps people.
He is a great person, but he's still, you know what I mean? But now he's doing good now.
He's doing great.
His life went back to, he's making good money with that camp that have, all the marijuana they're selling.
He's killing it.
He's killing it.
Tyson 2.0.
He does that.
Podcast, very popular.
So he's back. Hopefully, he continues doing the right thing now. But there's been hundreds.
And then, okay, on the other half.
Thousands of fighters that make millions, and they blow it.
Big G, what do you tell a fighter that his whole life he's dreaming of becoming a professional, he's a professional, but he never makes money with boxing? When is enough is enough, Robert?
No,
ask your dad really quick.
The first thing is, be smart about, if a lot of kids think boxing is going to save their fucking life and get the family rich.
They're going to get the Mayweather money.
The dads, the moms, they all think the same. A lot of them. But fucking boxing is very, very short, very small career. You gotta fucking stay in school. And a lot of those that maybe don't like school will get your own trade. Fucking get a fucking, plumbing, construction, electricity. So at least you can work for yourself. You don't have to work for somebody else. Do something. You shouldn't be ashamed of doing stuff like
That's
that.
True.
Nothing wrong with
it. But ask your dad, when should fighters, I'm not sorry, not talking about ability, like when, how long do you stay in the game before you're like, okay?
See, the fighters, a lot of them don't notice. It's us that have to tell them. It's us that have to talk to them and tell them,
you should get a job, yeah.
Yeah, when you have a fighter that's not hungry anymore, that wants to do it just to get a payday, if there's enough, you're gonna make some, we gotta be careful. Okay, let's make him the money, but maybe we gotta know that we gotta stop the fight when he starts getting hit or something, just so we can get that last payday. But, we have to be, we're the ones that have to tell them. Because a lot of fighters, most of the fighters won't understand. A lot of dads won't understand.
Because everybody wants to make as much as they can.
Yeah.